How's it going, bros? My name is Yashaboo, and today we got something good. We got a strength build video. Oh my god. And there he goes into the sunset. Anyway, it's basically a strength int build, so it's just enough of a split to get really good damage off of cold infusion, use Ruin's Greatsword, Radahn's Greatswords. It's essentially Stilovski's strength int build, pretty much. And the fashion is as well to reach that big boy poise. Anyway, let's just jump right into it. Let's slap these guys around. So, I started invading again, and like, you know, as dumb as that is, you know, as dumb of an idea as that is, I've had some fun, you know. Like, it's not as bad as I remembered it. It's kind of like riding a bike, getting back into it. That was a very intentional backstab, by the way. That was like a Giga Brain 5D chess play. Don't worry about it. Don't question if that was intentional. This guy, look at what happened in this game, man. Like, and watch this host. Watch the host. Look at him. Like, damn. That's just sad. Like, the Phantom just mashes out a hit stun with ultras, and then the host just gives completely up. Like, what happened to the game? Like, people mash at a hit stun now, with big boy weapons and with little guy weapons. Like, it's so weird. It's just turning into like a DS3 hellscape, which is kind of, I guess that's like the, that was probably the trajectory that this game was going to be on, just based on that Forza update. Oh damn, that cold broad got him. Yeah, just three dudes with ultras versus another dude with an ultra. This is good stuff. Unfortunately, all it takes to end a fight like this is like spacing and timing, and this guy's gonna mash at a hit stun too. Look at the game. Look at the state of it. It's like depressing. But I mean, it was a decent clip, I guess, but yeesh. Alright, so here's something you're not gonna see. Check this out. I'm just going. Look at what Gugs can do. This is two things that you're not going to see in these next two clips. So I don't care about being cold. I was born in the cold. I hit him with a heavy, and then I hit him with the second heavy and roll catch him. I don't think I've ever done that. I don't know why I ship outed him. I don't know. I didn't record enough of the invasion. Whatever, we'll move on. So this guy, this is something you will see. I'm just going to like roll catch him and die. But the host, the fight against the host is something that you got to see. Because it's 2024 right now. But I did not think that you'd see somebody land this. He just rolls into me in 2024. Like, what? How do you die to that? Like, there's no way he hasn't seen that. And then Redman, yeah. it's so weird to me. Anyway, this is this clip is awesome. I just came in and like pretty much just got an assist. I just like body blocked this twin blade host. It's like trying to get. Can't make it. Shit stuck. I'm away, son! Oh, that's good. That's good stuff. Oh, yeah, Shamshir. Man. Yeah, it's funny. I never got into Shamshir before the poise update, but like, now that it's like basically one of the most meta weapons. Started using it, and it's really a blast. Like, the spacing that you can do with it is really fun. There are a few Ashes of War that are really good on it. Like, it's just overall a really fun weapon. Oh. But yeah, it's especially good on strength. Oh, this one's pretty funny. So me and this Red are just trying to, like, get rid of this host in a timely manner. And, I think he has latency. And... Yeah, that was like a little bit of lag, that's probably why. So me and this Red are like looking at each other, and I'm like wiggling and shit, and he does like a fruity ass emote, and then we realize at the exact same moment that we hate each other. Like, I did not like his vibe, and he did not like mine. Okay, so this is just like basically... Attacking a team when they have an obstacle can make a three-man like a lot less big of a deal Yeah. Also, something sad that I've noticed, I'm going to have like a Dex video coming out soon, a meta Dex, and then a few videos on an arcane build, but the odd thing is that lances do so much less damage on a strength build than they do on a Dex, and that is like so fundamentally wrong to me. I mean, it like makes perfect sense just because of the damage and like the fact that it's mainly a power stance weapon. But it's like mainly a strength weapon. I don't know. It just seems weird. Like I wish it did more damage on strength, but I don't think that's ever gonna happen. Oh, this one's pretty good, I think. Yeah, I just like get this host like low. He's like a rune arced Jimmy Casual build, and yeah, I just get him low, and then I like just kind of walk toward him, and like look at him, and then he rolls off. Oh man. Ah, bow invasion, yeah. Bow. Yeah, this guy just starts like yeeting comets at me, so I decided to eat some of my own at him. He ain't gonna like what I eat at him. A little bit of that rain of arrows. Get one more. Yeah. That's what it's about. Oh yeah, Shamshir. I had an invasion like before this clip, these clips I guess. With that host specifically. Like I think he was trying to gank on me. But I think I beat his summon and forgot to clip it, and now I have this onslaught of blues to like deal with as I'm trying to kill him. That's another thing that's like fundamentally wrong with the game, aside from like Taunter's Tongue, is the fact that you just have like infinite blues. You have to run a gauntlet. Like solo hosts can reliably gank with blues just by like running away from the red for like 45 seconds. That's how crazy this game is. Like, I get it, invaders are supposed to lose, but, like, we're, like, really, really supposed to lose in Elden Ring. Only thing helping us is, like, the stupid TTK. Like, the time to kill. Like, people get three-shotted by my lances, sometimes two-shotted. On Dex, they get two-shotted even more often. But, yeah, getting that Shamshir roll catch. It's funny, the blue doesn't even save him, the PvE does. And that's kind of why I included this fight, was because of the golem giants, or whatever they're called. They make it kind of interesting, because we're all getting hit by this big goofy goober. Mainly the host is getting hit, but I think I get hit plenty. Missed the crit on that, but I think he just like gave up. I have no idea what spell he just used. If somebody could tell me, that'd be cool. I have no idea what that was. It like didn't do damage, and yeah, there he goes alone. He just kind of mashes. Yeah, I definitely had a run in with that guy. If I'm shit potting, jeez. Oh, this one's pretty good. This one showcases some of like the utility that a build like this has. That's probably what makes this build so good, is like Radahn's and being able to get people through walls. This was like the first time that I learned that you could do that. I'm pretty sure that wasn't intentional, that backstab there. But yeah, Radahn's is like extremely, extremely good for people who are camping, especially in an area like this that's so vertical and small. Anyway, here's the build. Here's the menu setup. Bunch of swaps. Mainly got power stancing stuff on the right side. You might want to pause it and take a peek. I went a little quick. But, yeah, I got the great bows at the bottom for the swaps. Got the Page of Stormhawks. Got Holy Ground and those shields there. Got a bunch of swaps and the talismans. And, yeah, here are the stats coming up here. That's just what I use for consumables. Yeah, there's the pouch. Got boluses. And yeah, those are the stats. Yeah, this build is probably the most fun build I have. in terms of like using invasions. Anyway, that's the end of the video. Subscribe if you enjoyed. There will be more. I'm invading pretty heavily, so yeah. Subscribe and goodbye.